Welcome everyone. Thanks a lot for staying with us. You're watching Plain Speak with me, Shivani Gupta. We're coming to you live from the CNN News 18 and Federal Bank Primetime Studio. The chilling rape and murder of 31-year-old junior doctor in Kolkata's Arjikar Medical College will now be probed by the CBI. Calcutta High Court ruled today that a CBI investigation was the only way to inspire confidence in people and doctors who've been agitating over this case. The court noted serious lapses in the hospital administration's response after the doctor was first found dead on Friday morning. They've taken into account also the parents of the victims, wanting an investigation by an independent body to ensure that evidence is not tampered with. The state government's conduct was also raised during the hearing, and the court pulled up the state government for giving a new role to Dr. Sandeep Ghosh shortly after his resignation from the said medical college, even raising doubts over the urgency with which he was rehabilitated. One demand has been met, but many others are still pending. That's why, despite the High Court urging doctors to call off their strike and go back to work, they are continuing to be on protest. While the BJP has welcomed this verdict, claiming vindication, the TMC says that the police did the best it could in the 4 days that it got. But with another case being transferred out of the police's jurisdiction by a court in West Bengal, questions remain over the faith in the state government's conduct, particularly the police's conduct. Did the TMC government then fail the victim and her family in this case? And will a CBI probe ensure speedy justice for her? We'll take that and more to our guests joining us in just a bit. First up, the division bench of Chief Justice T.S. Sivanangam and Justice Hiranmay Bhattacharya questioned the state government after multiple petitions were filed seeking a CBI probe in this case. This included a prayer from the victim's parents as well. Scathing observations made by the Calcutta High Court today, and of course a deadline of 10 a.m. that has been set for the case files to be handed over to the CBI. Let me just break down a few of those observations made by the court today. The court went on to say that it's surprising why the principal did not lodge a complaint initially. The deceased was a doctor in the same hospital, but no complaint was made by the hospital authorities. No significant probe has been made or investigation has been done by the police so far. This is an indictment of the state police. The administration was not with the victim or her family. The principal has not even given a statement. Victim's parents have apprehension on that the probe will be derailed, which is why they have taken into account the parents' wishes. The court has also gone on to say that it is justified in accepting prayers that evidence will be destroyed. Now, this is a damning indictment of the state of police work in the state. If the court believes that the allegations or apprehensions that someone could destroy evidence is credible. The court also says that them transferring this to CBI is to do justice and to inspire public confidence, which seems to be shaky. Principal Sandeep Ghosh shall remain on long leave. Principal shall not be reinstated until further notice, which is exactly what the government had done within hours of the principal first resigning. So why is so much of this discourse surrounded around this principal? Who is this Sandeep Ghosh exactly? He's now been ordered by the Calcutta High Court to take a long leave. And of course, the government's decision to transfer him to another hospital has been nullified. The judges noted that the grave circumstances surrounding the young woman's death did not impact Dr. Ghosh at all. Now, the former principal of Arjikar Medical College has a controversial past and is believed to be a powerful person. So, why is this person or individual controversial? Let's break down what we know. Sandeep Ghosh, one, was rehabilitated within 4 hours of resigning in another college. The protesting doctors had accused him of a cover-up. As far as the Arjikar case is concerned, his initial reaction and behavior was suspect. Reports suggest he has been shunted twice from Arjikar, but was reinstated soon after in all of those cases. He also faces allegations of taking bribes and rigging tenders multiple times. And there are a whole host of student agitation going on as far as the principal itself is concerned. Now, hours after this man resigned as the principal of the said college, he was appointed as the principal of Calcutta National Medical College and Hospital, where he had earlier served as the medical superintendent and vice principal. That decision also did not go down well with the protesting doctors at that particular new institute, and certainly the court has also taken very strict cognizance of this matter. This morning, students and junior doctors at the Calcutta National Medical College and Hospital were seen protesting at the gates of that college. These are visuals that we're bringing you of what transpired. There were go back slogans that were raised when the state government emissaries reached there to offer an olive branch to protesting doctors. MLA Swarn Kamal Saha and Minister in Bengal Javed Ahmed Khan had to return from the hospital without much headway after the protesters refused to budge from their stance or to listen to them or, you know, let them come in. The agitating doctors made it clear that they did not want what they called garbage, quote-unquote, of R.G. Kerr Medical College. Now, this is the kind of anger that is palpable as far as doctors in Kolkata and West Bengal are concerned. Of course, there are doctors all across the country who are protesting and raising their demands in this case, plus other demands that are emanating from a case like this. With CBI now being handed over the doctor's rape and murder case, the question that arises is, did the state government then fail the victim?
बाहर में सिक्योरिटी का बहुत बड़ा दुर्ग हुआ खड़े हुआ
बहुत
सिक्योरिटी था। हम लोग अगर कोई बात करने जाए तो डायरेक्ट उनसे बात नहीं करते थे। हम लोग को पूछना है कितना क्या पावर है, तो स्टूडेंट्स के जो डिमांड्स है, स्टूडेंट्स के जो प्रॉब्लम्स है उससे भी ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है।
इस्तीफा कर देनी चाहिए ममता बनर्जी।
Let it be taken as a commitment from the state government that we will ensure highest possible punishment to the culprit.
I want to go across to our guests joining us. Remember, there is a political element as far as this story is concerned, but this is much bigger than the politics that emanates not just in West Bengal or in any state where such cases come to light. So we will, of course, make an attempt to shift away from the politics as well. But joining me as far as our political guests are concerned, Anuja Kapoor, spokesperson of the BJP. Also, Shabnam Day is a political analyst, leans towards the TMC joining us. We'll also be joined by a couple of other experts. But I want to begin with Anuja first. Anuja, the BJP may feel a sense of vindication, but the reality is that a case like this, what has happened in this R.G. Kerr Medical College, it could happen anywhere. So this is a matter for us to be concerned in any case. This isn't really about, you know, which state it has transpired in.
Jai Shri Ram. Condolences to the family and another Nirbhaya shamed, blamed and not been given justice. You know, there are no words. It is not about political vendetta or not. Hmm. It is about the daughter of Bharat has again been put down by the system and or of the state. West Bengal, we have seen that various times. If you've seen Sandesh Khali, if you say, in Shahjahan case, you have seen how DJP Rajiv Kumar, the blue-eyed of Mamata Banerjee, was reinstated again. You know how this system is working with West Bengal. She even sat on dharna when the CBI was, in Sharda Chitfund case when they went to his house. Look at the chronology of Mamata Banerjee, how she's close to all those people. Those are the culprits of women being raped, women being assaulted, women being the victim of crime. She has a history of saving these people.
But in this case, there's no connection with Mamata Banerjee. Let's first get that out of the way. As far as the response of the state is concerned, there are allegations on the police. There is the allegation on the ACP of the area. There is an allegation against the erstwhile principal of this college. But what is the political connection?
The political connection is this, ma'am, that Mamata Banerjee, she reinstated Dr. Sandeep Ghosh again. You know, this is, she has a history of reinstating these people. Why I spoke about DJP Rajiv Kumar to tell you, to bring back, to, you know, to recall how Mamata Banerjee government works. How do you think Mamata Banerjee, being the CM, does not understand that the state police comes under her? And you are saying it is not connected. We are asking the resignation of health minister. We are asking the resignation of CM. We are also asking for Kolkata CP Vineet Goyal, personal physician of CM, and Dr. S.P. Das. And now we also, now Sandeep Ghosh is, we don't know where he's gone.
So well, the court has intervened as far as Sandeep Ghosh is concerned. But you raise a pertinent point. Let me go across to Shabnam Day, who's joining us. Why this love for Sandeep Ghosh? He doesn't really have an illustrious past. Students don't seem to like him. Students are suspicious of him. Why was he reinstated so quickly? What was the tearing hurry? In fact, if anything, the state government tainted itself with that action, Shabnam.
It is the matter of the transfer, and that is the administration matter. Mamata Banerjee, CM, she has taken up the prompt action, which the very shocking and very, means you can say that it's unspoken words incident happened. And she had, Mamata Banerjee has done Raj Dharma by immediately making a team of fit.
Well, it wasn't immediate.
Very expeditiously.
Shabnam, let's go one by one. I'll come to the police investigation point in just a bit. But there is a serious question here. Why did the state reinstate Sandeep Ghosh so quickly?
It is an administration matter. It is not in the hand of CM. CM didn't know about it also. So it has been done through administration process. And then today is the Honorable Court's order passed by Honorable Division Bench, headed by Chief Justice of Calcutta High Court, to direct him to leave the post by 3 p.m. And that is the sacred order and solemn order of the Honorable Court. And he had to leave for many days to vacate that position. That was the...
Okay, I'll come back to you on the question of whether the police also did right by the victim, and which is why even the parents don't seem to have much confidence as far as the state police's probe is concerned. Even if you could argue that 4 days or 5 days is not enough time for the police to crack a case, they could naturally need more time. But it's about faith in the system. But Yashavardhan Azad is a former IPS officer. He's joining me. Shabnam Day insists that reinstated this principal, Sandeep Ghosh, who students don't seem to have any trust over, is just a pure administrative matter. Do you buy this argument, especially after the kind of incident that has taken place? The principal didn't seem to be much concerned, was seen to be blaming the victim and her whereabouts for this?
Well, shaming the victim is the worst thing you can do, and anybody who has done it should be castigated. There's no doubt about it. But in terms of actually what really happened, you can't really blame the principal for everything, because you had a security officer also. It is the security officer who should be sacked. Where the principal's responsibility lies is the fact that this was made aware to the principal, the security officer, and the others that this man has been dealing with, you know, wrong things in the hospital. And in fact, his record was well known. The principal should have immediately cracked down, written to the police that this man should be kicked out of this place. Secondly, You see, you understand the civic volunteers are people who are not the police. They are attached with the police. They are political appointments. And 1,50,000 of them are floating around in West Bengal. Now, this man was attached to the police outpost. The police outpost, you have people there attached to the hospitals for dealing with medico-legal cases. And these people sometimes become larger than life. And some of them even misuse this facility, while some of them are extremely helpful to even the doctors for registering cases and also helpful to the people, the families, to get them access to the doctors. Now, this fellow went rogue. It was known earlier, and therefore he should have been kicked out. That is where the principal's role, the security officer's role, and the ACP role or whatever comes.
But that's precisely why the students don't seem to have much trust in this principal. Because as you're saying, these are civic volunteers who are political appointees. Clearly, the accused in this case was familiar not just with the territory, but would have had quote-unquote friends. And it is precisely the suspicion that he's being saved somehow, that he could be saved somehow, and if there are other accomplices, could be saved somehow because of this political patronage, Mr. Azad.
No, you see, he has been arrested. The trace of blood has been found on his shoes. He cannot escape anyway, no matter what he does, number one. Number two, the issue is that since this was the way brutally the doctor has been raped and murdered, and you know, the video recording of the post-mortem is there. I'm very happy that it was done. Now, once from that, it does appear that it would have been difficult for one man to do this. Therefore, it's important to crack down. And I don't know why the CCTV has not been properly seen so far, that once you look at that properly, you'll be able to find out, or through his interrogation, who are the others involved. And I said it yesterday on your channel only, because of this, so many allegations, it'll be better to hand it over to the CBI. And I'm happy that the case has gone to CBI now, which I'm sure will crack the case.
I'm also joined by Dr. Rohan Krishnan, who's president of FAIMA, one of the medical associations that has been protesting as well. You're hearing what some of our guests are saying as far as the principal's role is concerned. Is it that this case is being used to somehow settle other scores as well, bring in other issues as well, and, you know, agencies like various medical associations are kind of, you know, making a truck with this case, but also bringing in other demands as well, not really focusing on what is a pure crime issue. They're expanding it to other issues and also taking it out on avenues where they shouldn't take it out, for the principal, for example.
I don't think, madam, you would have asked this question if some of your relatives or someone from press would have undergone this kind of brutality in their premises. What has happened is the most tragic story of this country, and it is one of the saddest moments for all of us. Usually when a parent calls their child and they hear that their daughter has reached the hospital, they feel secured and safe that now, okay, she is in the hospital, now I can sleep in peace. But what has happened in this case is one of the darkest moments in the humanity and in our country. So about what you are talking about, principal, we raise these issues because the to the principal and continuously about the doctors, that there should be separate the doctor's duty room, there should be proper security in the hospital premises, there should be a CCTV camera should be installed everywhere, and there should be a separate washroom for lady doctor when she is going for 36-hour duty. Not only principal, even the health secretary is accountable. If you are opening medical college, and what the college which we are talking about is one of the topmost colleges of the West Bengal. And if this is the situation in one of the topmost colleges of the West Bengal, how safe is a woman working in PHC in West Bengal is a big kind of question mark. Apart from that, when what we are raising, that different issues, one issue that we are raising, that from a long period of time, the doctors are battling the Central Protection Act for healthcare workers, and we are battling for it. Since COVID, it was enacted, and then after that, it came to a halt, and no action has been taken upon it. So these are very serious issues and allegations.
No, there is that is a very serious issue, Dr. Rohan. Nobody is denying that, but that is not directly linked to a rape and murder that happens in a hospital or a medical college. That is the point that I was trying to drive. But one of our guests suggests that yes, there are lapses as far as the principal is concerned, particularly on the security. What is it that you want to raise against this particular man, Dr. Sandeep Ghosh? You've seen how the state reinstated him to a different college. Students there also are protesting. Why this hurry, according to you? Why do you think this has happened?
That is what which puts a big question mark on the state government. Hmm. And that is why the faith is lost in the entire system of state government.
Hmm.
When this issue happened, the principal and the higher authorities of the medical colleges initially tried to put it as a suicide case.
Mm-hmm.
Upon protest, postmortem was done. Isn't it shameful enough, and isn't it more than enough to remove the principal and whosoever is concerned? I have no friendship or enmity with whoever the principal of the college is.
Mm.
But it is a major lapse on his part that something like this has happened to his student. And he himself is trying to cover up the cases.
Yeah, and that's so precisely what the court seemed to say today too, that this man's behavior, response, reaction is suspect. Ms. Day, respond to the doctor who's, who's questioning the state's intent and the lack of faith, lack of trust in the police that initially tried to project it as a suicide.
The victim's parents, they had faith in state government police for the investigation they started, and they also kept faith in our PM Mamata Banerjee, who is also a female chief minister, and she had prompted acted in regarding making
Madam,
the
you pressurize
seat
people.
Probe.
And then you say that they have faith in you. This is something which is very
not
laughable.
Pressurizing.
Obviously, you guys have pressurized
minister
them.
Talk,
I think that it is shameful
CM
that such
to,
incident has happened
to the victim's parents.
Hospital.
Okay, once again, the victim's parents' wishes were also for an independent probe. They certainly did not have faith in the state police, ma'am. Ms. Day, that is what transpired in court today. But Dr. Rohan, let her finish, please.
Court has taken that observation, that the CBI. But have you seen that CBI in the other matters, other probes, like Rijuanu's case or Shanti Niketan Tagore Nobel Prize medal theft case 2004, Rijuanu death case 2007, and Taposh Malik murder case 2006, have they succeeded in concluding the case? They have,
we are not, we are
not
even questioning whether they have succeeded or
examination
they have
properly of the witnesses.
The question is about the faith in the system which
they
was lost.
Are not succeeding.
The question
but
is about that
the
you did
seat,
not allow,
this,
you were not in the
seat,
mood to get a postmortem done. You buried the body in a hurry. There were initially you guys told that it is a it might be a suicide case. Initially there was a lot of pressure upon the students and the resident body over there. We had to come up in the picture because they requested us, and because they were in a lot of fear that if Delhi does not speak, nothing will happen and this life will be lost for vain. They are under constant pressure. What are you talking about? That
no
we don't
constant
care whether
pressure.
Okay, let Shabnam Day respond for 30 seconds. Then I'll go back across to Anuja as well, who's been waiting. Shabnam,
West
yes.
Bengal state is the safest place for the female, and NCHRC already declared that West Bengal is one of the safest place. This incident happened. It was very untoward incident and very shocking incident. It happened, but the steps and prompt actions taken by Mamata Banerjee CM expeditiously by forming SIT to probe the case with a team of three ships in so
yeah.
that the
none of that assuaged the fears of the doctors or the victim's parents. Anuja, Shabnam Day says West Bengal is one of the safest states for women. The BJP has been accused of, you know, picking up these cases from West Bengal purely for political gain.
I would like to just
always
ask
they do.
Do
BJP always do for political
excuse
gain.
Excuse me, ma'am.
One by one, please. Yes.
I would also like to ask the person who is sitting from TMC, do you think Calcutta High Court is also connected to a political game? Have you seen the observations which has been talked about by the Calcutta? They did not want to wait for your 7 day, what Mamata Banerjee said, that please wait for 7 day and an SIT would be doing it.
You do not want your Calcutta High Court.
Excuse me, ma'am.
You have an audacity.
To sit here and talk about the family of the victims. Do you know how many victims are? Have you seen your statistics? Have you seen your statistics, ma'am? Do you see the observation that is the court in West Bengal? This is the history of shaming, blaming, raping, murdering the women in this country for religious purpose and greed. Do you see what you have done? West Bengal has become the kingdom of the world for women.
Why don't you speak about women? Why don't you speak about Manipur? Why don't you speak about the MP lady?
Okay, one by one. Can I just come in? You know, this is exactly the problem. While there may be questions that can be raised,
you should be ashamed.
Anuja ji, I'll come back to you. While there are, of course, serious questions that even the court has asked, the state government, the police, the administration, and certainly there can be a case made that there have been instances of crimes against women where the West Bengal police's or the West Bengal administration or government's response has not been up to the mark. But Yashovardhan Azad, I want to come to you. You wanted to come in. Yes, very quickly, sir, then I'll pose my question.
You see, in this political battle, we are losing because of the deceased. You know, there are very, very serious issues in government hospitals, and I'm glad that young doctor has raised it. You know, these are things which need to be, you know, absolutely removed, that the gang of touts which are there, number one. Number two, the pressures under which the doctors work, and I am aware because my elder brother was a doctor in AIIMS here. The kind of conditions with these doctors work in is amazing. They are doing continuous duty at night. Imagine the work of the ladies. As it is, they are protesting against the BNS section of 106 in which they'll be, you know, punished for negligence. The least which the governments can do is to provide them security. In fact, to tell you frankly, they need better rooms, they need better washrooms, they need better anti-rooms. And you know, if you do this, there will be a sense of kind of feeling of oneness and identity among these doctors.
Okay.
This incident does not, let us not talk about NCRV and women, whether they are safer or not. We are talking about this particular incident. I'm glad this has gone to the CBI and now the case will be unraveled. But the situation will remain the same unless you fix things in the hospitals.
No, absolutely. No denying that conditions in which our junior doctors and others are working particularly are absolutely horrendous. And there needs to be greater weight put behind that bill, that act, which protects them, particularly from violent patients or their family members. And we are all for that. But Yashovardhan Azad, the question I wanted to ask you was, do you smell something suspicious or fishy with the police's initial response? The ACP concern has been suspended purely because there was an attempt to make it look like it was not as serious a crime or was even a suicide. People are also saying that the other accomplices, which they believe are very much part of this crime, have still not been found, were found by the local police, and it shouldn't have taken them this long. Mr. Azad.
See, Shivani, I don't think it would matter at all what is the ACP thinks or what he's trying to do. Because in any case, in a death like this, there'll be a post-mortem, number one. You cannot deny it, no matter who tries. And the kind of injuries, etc., looking into it, you know, as prima facie, it cannot be termed as suicide.
Okay.
So, you know, anybody, no matter how partial you are, you cannot write it off. And now in the new BNS, the post-mortems also should have been video recording done, which has not been done in the BNS incidentally. So in this particular, that is number one.
No, but
number
if it two, is your administration and everybody is in cahoots, surely you can fudge a case. That's the suspicion,
no,
which
cannot.
Is why the
you
court
cannot.
Said that we don't want evidence to be destroyed, which is why we're transferring this to CBI.
You cannot destroy these evidence because the marks are already there and the postmortem has already been done. The issue there
but
is...
But evidence linking the accused to the body, those could be destroyed.
No, they cannot be destroyed because they have already been found on the shoes. In fact, that is where you will say that the police is not hiding because they found
one of the accused after shoes. Much pressure built in this case. I'm talking about the
not
initial
there.
24-hour
no.
reaction.
Money, see, I agree that the civic volunteer turned out to be a rogue. This kind of thing doesn't happen only in India. It happens all over the world.
Okay. Okay, Dr. Rohan, you want to come in? The court has certainly listened to some of the demands that were being made by the students plus also the parents. Are you satisfied with what the court has done today, a CBI probe? What is your message to the state government still?
The court has done the right thing. We appreciate their honor and they honor their judgment where they have asked to give all the files and everything to the CBI. What we expect from state government is to do something to improve the situation over there. The resident doctors have few other demands which is there. Kindly meet them so that such incidents are never repeated. This is our only aim and motto of doing a strike pan-India, just to support the diseased and their family and our colleagues from West Bengal, that whatever has happened should never ever happen in our nation.
Absolutely. Well, certainly, as far as crimes like these at a medical college is concerned, it shakes the very belief and conscience of the entire country that something like that can happen in a hospital premise to a doctor who's working there. If they are not safe, then who is safe? And where are you safe? That's the big question that this is throwing up. I do thank our guests for joining us. Let's also listen into some voices from on the ground and why this case has really shaken up everybody.
आप बताइए कि क्या डिसीजन हुआ?
देखिए, डिसीजन जो हम लोगों को अभी बोला गया था, कल रात में हम लोगों का एक जनरल बॉडी मीटिंग हुआ था, अलग-अलग कॉलेजेस के, अलग-अलग सारे मेडिकल कॉलेजेस के, ऑलमोस्ट सारे वेस्ट बंगाल के रिप्रेजेंटेटिव और लोग आए थे, उनसे बात हुई थी और हमने कल रात में एक प्रेस बाइट दिया है कि हम लोग की क्या क्या डिमांड है. आज जो नई खबर आई है कि CBI को हैंड ओवर होगा, हम लोग वेलकम कर रहे हैं इसको. हम लोग तो चाहते हैं जो जहाँ पर भी बेस्ट हो वही चीज़ हो, बट अभी भी जो हम लोग का डिमांड नंबर वन जो प्राइमरी डिमांड है कि अक्यूज को पकड़ा जाए, हम लोग को बताया जाए कि एक एक्यूज है, ज़्यादा एक्यूज है, कितने एक्यूज हैं, हम लोग अभी तक कोई आइडिया नहीं है इस चीज़ के बारे में. तो वी वेलकम द डिसीजन ऑफ CBI, बट अभी तक हम लोग का जो डिमांड है, दैट डिमांड एंड द स्ट्राइक विल स्टिल कंटिन्यू.
हम लोग ये सुन के बहुत खुश हैं. हम लोग को मन में बहुत शांति मिल रहा है कि हाँ, अभी CBI का हाथ में गया है तो प्रमाण के साथ, सही प्रमाण के साथ अभी ज्योति को पकड़ा जरूर जाएगा.
यही हमारा डिमांड था. हायर अथॉरिटीज ऑलरेडी रिजाइन, बट ये एक जो डिमांड था ये हमारा फुलफिल हो. ये जो मास रैली हुआ था जो अभी भी हो रहा है, इसके वो दबाव में ये जो हुआ ना CBI का, अब में हमको लगता है कि इन्वेस्टिगेशन प्रॉपर होगा एंड वी विल गेट सम मोर क्लूज दैट हु आर द कल्प्रिट्स. ओके, एंड वी डिमांडेड अबाउट द CBI इंक्वायरी.
अच्छा हुआ CBI को मिला है, क्योंकि कोलकाता पुलिस जितनी स्पीड से काम कर रहा था उससे जस्टिस तो नहीं मिलता. अभी अभी क्या, कभी भी नहीं मिलता. अभी अगर CBI अगर सच ठीक से देख ले तो अच्छा होगा.